With development quadrupling over the next decade, the world wants in. And Alberta is open for business. But are they driving a hard bargain or selling Canadian sovereignty at liquidation prices?
You can't build the world's largest energy project, or the world's largest capital project for that matter, and not change the nation. Canada now has this image of some kind of emerging energy superpower, and so more and more the politics of the country have to deal with oil and money from oil and the environmental problems that come in particular from dirty oil. And the tar sands has implications for every aspect of life.
The rise of Canada as an energy superpower is tied to the collapse of America's sense of invincibility. The American dream had been fueled by a steady supply of cheap, available oil. But on September 11th, 2001, everything changed. Oil supply and pricing had been stable for 20 years. Now the only thing certain is uncertainty. Middle East oil is tainted by terrorism, and oil goes from a simple commodity to the key component of Western security.
After terrorism and a nuclear or biological weapon, energy security is the number three threat, I think, after that for our security in the United States and, for that matter, Canada.
Locking down a secure supply of oil becomes an American obsession. But increasingly, oil is a closed market, with 90% of conventional reserves controlled by nationally owned companies. These companies, as in Venezuela and Russia, often have their own geopolitical agendas.